My mother was Swiss. Her father was a younger brother of a very successful silk business in Zurich. And she came, when he came over to set up the American branch, and she was 14 when she came, and along with her mother, I would love to have known her then, because she was ended up by being quite a remarkable woman. She was someone who had a very strong personality, and but at the same time, though, to fit in with the Swiss background which she had, she also, the role of the women in the family and the household was definitely sort of a slave, really, and it was, and she had to do and believe and agree to what seemed to me now was terrible things, but she managed it perfectly because she kept her independence and she kept her intelligence and she just simply let all the other things wash away, and even her attitude towards her father was very traditional. He was the boss. And so when he married my father automatically became the boss. And I always remember her telling me that when the Kaiser entered Belgium in the First World War, he arrived down for breakfast and announced very firmly that henceforth German will never be talked in this room, or in this house, and he said, and it never was. They talk Schwyzerdütsch, Swiss, and they talk French and English, of course, but the true German was out, and that was a disaster for me, because I was wanted to become a biologist, and in my day as a young student, almost all the good stuff was written in German, and I couldn't understand a word of it. All I could do is look at the pictures, I even once brought a paper and asked my grandmother to translate it for me, or help me translate it. And it was on sex in Chlamydomonas, which is a single-cell alga, green alga. And it couldn't be more innocent a paper. And she looked at it before she even started. She looked at it and she said, "What kind of things are they teaching you these days?" And I've calmed her down. She eventually got it translated. She was really a remarkable woman because I think in many ways she was more intelligent and had a better brain than my father, although my father was no... And yet she managed to suppress it in a way so that everybody else around her thought they were fantastic. including her children, actually. She never completely approved of me, but she thought I was intelligent but pig-headed. That was her. I'm sure she was right, too.